a football legend in Arkansas, and a lasting example for underdogs everywhere, Brandon Burlsworth is remembered this weekend with a camp in his name.
After being forced to go virtual last year, the Brandon Burlsworth camp is back to being in person here in Little Rock, honoring the greatest college football walk-on of all time and a Razorback great, building these kids' characters, their skills, oh yeah, and let's not forget about some fun.
I don't even know whose team is on my team.
Now, set up, go!
A guy who walked on, did everything the right way, earned a scholarship, became an All-American.
Did he score right there?
That's a touchdown.
He didn't get to fulfill because of the tragic death. Years and years later, how this is still going on. Having 300 plus kids here, COVID is still going on, things like that just shows how much that he made an impact on everyone.
After the years-long camp was held in Burlsworth's hometown of Harrison on Friday, it hit War Memorial in Little Rock on Saturday morning. 15 former Razorbacks, some being Burlsworth's old teammates and some known as Hog Greats, were there to mentor kids and honor the legacy of an all-time Razorback great lost too soon.
The story is going to always resonate because everybody at some point in their life feels like an underdog, child, adult. So if somebody can do that at that level, you know, what was that blueprint?
Learned the work ethic values that Brandon stood for. And I think Tommy Tice, his former coach, does a good job of honoring him with just the way that this is run.
In the mix, as always, is Brandon's brother, Marty, who runs the camp.
All right, going good.
Burlsworth's roommate in Arkansas in the 90s says if he was still here today, he'd be a little embarrassed by all the attention, but grateful that he's affecting so many. What turned a walk-on into an All-American? For Burlsworth, it was fundamentals, and at his camp, those who've played at the highest level pass it down to the youth, grades 3rd through 9th.
Yeah, the fundamentals, the details, that's what made him a good player. You know, going from a walk-on to an All-American, it was meticulous detail with football, and so that's how we've honored his memory.
No rushing the quarterback!
Picking up a fumble, scooping and scoring, tackling circuit, you know, you're going with the bags and the dummies. Even with the linemen, you know, we worked on getting into a basic stance, and then we also switched and let them work on the defensive side of the ball as well. So they get to learn two different sides of the ball, and it's from people that actually played at the highest level of college football.
Share with them what Brandon did, his work ethic. I talked today about his priorities. You know, we thought he was obsessive compulsive disorder, but a lot of that was just he had habits and he was strict with them.
Yeah! Brandon Burlsworth passed away in 1999, shortly after going pro. 22 years later, his memory still lives on, even in kids, and in large part thanks to the movie Greater on Netflix.
We went to film and then on Netflix now. They did a great job with the movie on how, I mean, it really does line up well with what he did in college, because I was there all 5 years with him, kind of showcasing what he went through and what he had to do to become great or greater.
I think the movies made a big difference in that too, of keeping him, I guess, just within thought, keeping him in memory.
Nick Walters, Fox 16.